So one of the key aspects of requirement development is really getting the technical experts in engineering, safety and mission assurance, health and medical, and also for us, it was the flight operations directorate. It was the mission operations director at the time, but getting their buy-in on the requirement set. And so really, they were part of the partnering and the tailoring strategies that we had. We did have to overall agree on some key philosophical structures for the set of requirements. So the first one was this basic idea that we were just developing what's the core set of requirements. We were not responsible for mission success. So that was a very important construct that we had to get all the technical authorities and the missions operations directorate to agree to in the development of the requirement set. The second thing was this idea that really I was depending on their expertise to make sure that the requirement set was the requirement set for this. You know, it was a big change to typically the technical authorities have, and they kind of viewed it like it's they had this mesh or the spider web of overlapping requirements that they kind of viewed as like a safety net in case you got a requirement wrong. And so in a lot of ways, what they would do is they would kind of have all the set of requirements and you had several overlapping requirements. And then, and what it did was it ensured that, well, maybe the contractor ended up weaseling their way out of this requirement, but there was this other requirement that was going to get them. And you always, you know, you always were going to make sure that there wasn't any kind of hole in the requirement set. So we really had to spend a lot of time with them, getting them comfortable that the requirement set that we had were absolutely the core set that was going to need to be there for from a safety perspective. I think that if we wouldn't have had some of the visiting vehicle experience behind us, it would have been very tough to convince them of that. The areas where it was toughest to convince people of that was really in the operations aspect. Because the visiting vehicles at the time that we were developing the commercial requirement set, ATV and HTV hadn't flown yet. Now, that operations set of requirements, it became a lot easier to tailor those and work through those after we went through the first ATV missions and the first HTV missions. And it became, you got a better sense of the operational margin that's really there in visiting vehicles. That's very tough to do until you are in that operational realm and you really get a sense of the risk that's really there from a vehicle perspective. When we first started working proximity operations requirements, it was like the teams would almost talk about the relative motion between the two vehicles. Like it's like you've got this bullet coming at the space station. Well, what you start realizing, and with the constraints of the requirements and everything else, and when I went to my first HTV berthing and you saw, it was like watching paint dry as this vehicle, that last little bit was coming in, and you realized it's not exactly like a bullet coming at the space station. It's obviously it's still, they're both going very fast and you have to be very careful but there's time to affect, and there's some things you just have a better understanding of the relative motion of the vehicles and really the operational scenarios and how these particular vehicles are going to and the requirements that kind of protected from an operational perspective. Sometimes that's tough to determine if you haven't really had that operational experience. And so I think all of that and all of that working together, and honestly, having the technical experts and the authorities part of the team really helped establish that core set. And then it really made sure that at the end, when we were getting ready to actually go through the flight readiness review process for the demonstration vehicles. You know, they also really understood the risk of the vehicles and were able to buy into the risk of the vehicles for those demonstration missions.